Hello astronomers! Today let's talk about one of the most common and important questions in astrophotography. How do you choose the right camera for deep sky imaging? If you're just starting out, you might already have a DSLR or mirrorless camera, like this Nikon Z6 I have here. And that's great! Modern digital cameras are very capable, and they can be a fantastic way to begin capturing galaxies, nebulas, and star clusters. But once you start exploring long exposure astrophotography, you quickly realize that not all cameras are created equal. And that's when a dedicated cooled astronomy camera starts to make a big difference. DSLRs and mirrorless cameras are convenient because they are versatile. You can use them for everyday photography and then attach them to your telescope with a single adapter ring. However, they are not optimized for astrophotography. They are not cooled, so long exposures quickly introduce thermal noise. They also include an ear-cut filter inside, which is designed for accurate daytime colors but reduces the camera's sensitivity to the red light emitted by the hydrogen alpha nebulae, some of the most beautiful targets in the night sky. That's why a cooled astronomy camera like this ATIK Apx26 I have here is the best choice for deep sky astrophotography. It actively regulates the sensor temperature, drastically reducing thermal noise. But when you start looking for a camera for deep sky astrophotography, you quickly realize there are so many models out there. So, how do you find the one that best matches your telescope? One of the first things to look at is the sensor size. The size of the sensor directly determines the field of view you'll get with your telescope. For example, a full-frame sensor, 36 by 24 mm, covers a much larger sky area than an APS-C or smaller chip. So a larger sensor helps you to capture more of the object in one frame. This is especially important in deep sky astrophotography, because many targets have a large apparent size in the sky. Using a larger sensor gives you a better chance of fitting the entire object within your frame. However, a large sensor also requires your telescope to have a well-corrected field. Many telescopes, especially refractors, need a field flattener in front of the camera to keep stars sharp across the entire frame. Newtonian reflectors usually need a coma corrector for the same reason. And here's an important point. These correctors are designed to work at a specific back focus distance, meaning the distance from the corrector to the camera sensor. If your sensor is not positioned exactly at that distance, the stars won't be perfectly sharp across the image. That's why using a precise mechanical adapter and spacer is critical for deep sky imaging. The second factor is pixel size. Each pixel on the sensor collects light from a tiny area of the sky, and the relationship between pixel size and telescope focal length determines your image scale, or how detailed your images will be. If the pixels are too large, you'll lose fine details. If they are too small, you'll oversample, meaning you'll record more resolution than the seeing conditions allow. A good rule of thumb is to match your pixel size and focal length to get between 1 and 2 arc seconds per pixel, depending on your typical scene conditions. So when you choose a camera, look at the pixel size carefully. It's one of the most important specs for matching it to your telescope. Next question. Should you choose a color or monochrome camera? A color camera, often called one-shot color, is easier to use. You take one exposure and get a color image directly. That makes ideal for beginners or anyone imaging from dark skies where light pollution isn't a big problem. A monochrome camera, on the other hand, provides more sensitivity. You then use filters like LRGB for color or narrowband filters such as H-alpha, O3 and S2 to build up your final image. This process takes longer, but it gives you maximum flexibility and superior results, especially under light-polluted skies. Now, let's return to one of the biggest advantages of dedicated astronomy cameras – cooling. By keeping the sensor at a stable low temperature, even 13 to 14 degrees below ambient, a cooled camera drastically reduces thermal noise and makes calibration with dark frame far more consistent. This is absolutely essential when you're capturing long exposures, sometimes several minutes each, to reveal faint galaxies or nebulae. So while you can use a DSLR or a mirrorless camera to get started in deep sky astrophotography, if your goal is high quality deep sky images, a cooled astronomy camera will always deliver cleaner, more detailed results. So to summarize, start with the camera you have. Even a mirrorless or DSLR camera can teach you a lot. But if you want to push your images farther, consider upgrading to a cooled camera. Choose your sensor size to match your telescope's corrected field of view. Choose a pixel size that fits your telescope's focal length and scene conditions. And decide between a color camera for simplicity or a monochrome camera for the best possible quality, especially under light pollution. Astrophotography is a journey, and choosing the right camera for deep sky imaging is one of the most exciting steps. Because the moment you see your first long exposure image of a nebula or a galaxy appear on your screen, you will know it was worth it. And of course, for more content that will help you to explore the universe like a pro, subscribe to our channel and clear skies!